Simon & Schuster Audio presents Ready for Anything: Productivity Principles for Work and Life by David Allen. Read by the author. Introduction. Making it easy to take it easy.
Maximum productivity is making something happen, furniture, freeways, or fun, with as little effort as possible. The fact that we have effort at all, though, implies that we confront resistance and impediments when we want to get anything done. Improving productivity has a lot to do with dealing more effectively with the hindrances, barriers, and distractions that show up in our way, anything that opposes or weakens our forward motion. In a totally frictionless world, everything would just appear as soon as it was imagined. There would be little need to train for greater flexibility and focus, or to install better systems and approaches. In the world you and I inhabit, however, to really get what we want most effectively, we have to be ready for anything. And there are things we can all do, anytime, that make it easier to take things in stride and stay the course. I spent more than 2 decades exploring the best methods to achieve a more relaxed, positive, and sustainable way to live and work. And as a management consultant and productivity coach, I've helped thousands of professionals implement what I've discovered to be the best ways to work more productively and get more enjoyment from what they're doing. When people gain a method of achieving that kind of balance in their day-to-day endeavors, no matter what's going on, they have easier access to more of their intuition and creativity. They become better at processing information, managing their thoughts and feelings, focusing on results, and trusting their judgments about what to do next. When people know they have a process in place to handle any situation, they are more relaxed. When they're relaxed, everything improves. More gets done with less effort, and a host of other wonderful side effects emerge that add to the outcomes of their efforts and the quality of their life. The methods I teach came from the behaviors and the systems I discovered that work the best to keep us at our best. Since the early 1980s, they have been tested and proven highly effective from the ground up for both individuals and organizations. The steps of this discovery and this process were described in my first book, Getting Things Done: The Art of Stress-Free Productivity. While I was uncovering and implementing the details of the what, when, and how that made up the heart of my programs, I started doing something else. I began writing about the why behind these steps. Why did they work so well? There seemed to be underlying principles that wove themselves in and through the methodology, factors that held true no matter when, where, or with whom they were applied. I began compiling a set of principles that seemed to lie at the foundation of productive behavior and writing informal essays about the implications and applications of those truths in everyday life. I started to enlarge on my core premise that one's ability to be productive was directly proportional to one's ability to relax. I dug further and discovered that people didn't need more discipline as such. They needed a disciplined approach. They didn't need to work harder. They needed to define their work better at multiple levels of detail and stay focused on all of them simultaneously. Behind all this lay the mind-like-water concept, an image I'd come across years ago while studying karate. When you throw a pebble into a pond, what does the water do? It responds with total appropriateness to the force and mass of the rock. It does nothing more and nothing less. It doesn't overreact or underreact. It doesn't react at all. It simply interacts with whatever comes to it and then returns to its natural state. The water can do that only by design. A human being can act this way only if he or she has a conscious system in place, and if that system is built on principles that can withstand chaos and stress. Those principles must be aligned with something deeper in our nature. 2 years after I began writing the essays, I decided to write and distribute a newsletter to those who were becoming familiar with my methods. The feedback was overwhelmingly positive. People seemed hungry for reinforcement of the basics, exploration of the subtleties, and the adventure of the surprises produced by some of the simplest techniques, tools, and awarenesses. It was time to put this material together into a program of its own. The essays in this program have been sorted into the 4 major areas of productive behavior they support: completion, focus, structure, and action. The principles and essays grouped as such are meant not to be limited to these headings or to give an exhaustive exposition of those topics, but rather to stimulate your own thinking and validations of better ways to handle things. This program will likely validate much of what you already know and do that works, but it will also challenge you to apply that awareness in a much more conscious and consistent manner, and that's where the real power lies. Whether you approach this program ad hoc or straight through, I invite you to allow the bigger picture of a dynamic, positive readiness for life to emerge as you listen. The ready state of the martial artist is not a passive, reactive, or finite one. It is totally dynamic, alive, creative, and expansive. But it's not free. It is enabled by increasingly refined training and experience with work and life. May these principles serve as road signs and guideposts along your way.
Part 1. Clear your head for creativity, or getting the loose ends to leave you alone.
It's crazy. We don't have time to get our work done because of all the work we have to do. And we'd be so much better at the details if we just didn't have them to deal with. Mosquitoes can ruin the hunt for big game. There is light at the end of this tunnel, but the way out is through. Sometimes the biggest gain in productive energy will come from cleaning the cobwebs, dealing with old business, and clearing the decks, cutting loose debris that's impeding forward motion.
Cleaning up creates new directions.
Completion of open loops, whether they be major projects or boxes of old stuff we've yet to purge and organize, prepares the ground for cleaner, clearer, and more complete energy for whatever shows up. We're often not sure what's next or what to tackle. At that point, just clean or complete something. Something obvious and in front of you right away. Soon you'll have the energy and clarity to know what's next, and you'll have cleared the decks for more effective responsiveness on every front. Process your in-basket, purge your emails, or clean your center desk drawer. You've got to do it sometime anyway. Prepared for the unknown? Something is coming, probably within a few days, that's going to change your world. You don't see it yet. You don't know what it's about, but it's there, rolling inexorably forward, destined to throw you a curve that you do not expect. It could show up sooner or later, but it will show up. Trust me. Write down these words exactly 4 weeks from today on your calendar. David Allen said a month ago that something was coming I couldn't foresee that would affect me significantly. Prove me wrong. Are you ready? Is that unexpected event or input going to add insult to injury by making you feel more out of control? Or are you going to see it as the next creative opportunity that takes you to a new level of expression and contribution? How are you preparing for the surprises that the new experience will invariably throw your way? I think there are basically two levels to handle for any unforeseen opportunity. Number one, the spiritual. If God is all and you're part of that, just relax. Number two, all the rest. For this, you must get your act together so you can shift gears as required. An old Asian proverb says, "The more you sweat in peace, the less you bleed in war." The military model is not a bad one. In the armed forces, if you're not fighting, you're training. Most people get ready for change a few days before a long vacation, when they divorce and have to sell everything they own and move, or when some other major life event causes them to rethink it all and get some clarity around their commitments and their stuff. They're cleaning up, closing up, and renegotiating all their agreements with themselves and others. I suggest you do that weekly. And get yourself organized enough so that when a staff meeting is late to start, you're processing your in-basket, or cranking down your FYI to read stack. Or when you're waiting for your spouse to get ready, like actually ready, you're checking to see if there's a phone call you could make. I know very few people on the planet who care enough about their time and what they're doing every minute to maximize those kinds of windows. If you weren't taking advantage of your time that way, I'd ask yourself, why not? When's the last time you updated your projects list, those things that take more than one action to complete, and brought it current with next actions for each one placed in your system? The degree to which you haven't done that is the degree to which you are enduring unnecessary stress. And if you don't have one yet...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.